Well, hi, everybody, and thanks for tuning in to Moodle Support Theater. In our last episode, we dealt with setting up your grade book using sum of grades. In this edition, we're going to use simple weighted means of grades, and there's a lot of improvements I think you're really going to like. Now, if you're watching these in order, you're going to recognize this is the identical screen to the last video. We have the activities section in the lower left-hand corner that is reflecting accurately all of the content in the center section, and the reason that works is we built all of our courses using the activity drop-down here on the front page. If you saw the last one, this is going to be redundant. Go get a sandwich. If you're just checking this one out, it's very important we direct your attention to topic area 4, the faculty grade updates. Let's give it a click. I need to make mine just a little bigger. Depends on how your screen is set up. This is a screenshot from the Moodle Faculty User's Guide, and the area is topic area 5, as you can see up there where it says grade book basics. The videos, that's this center section, we're changing those. That thing is going to look different when you get there. But the options on how to set up your grade book, that's brand new and it's got a lot of good information. And I always suggest you combine the videos with the written information. It'll give you a really good head start. Of course, you're welcome to drop into the Moodle office in Library 315 anytime. Appointments are nice, but we, you know, get your hand stamped so you can come back in. We are happy to help you out whenever you can get here. Okay, we are going to go to the gradebook by selecting the tab at the top. And once inside the gradebook, we're going to choose categories and items. And this should look very similar to the thing you saw in the last video. It's the identical set of assignments, but we've made some major changes. Notice at the very top it says weighted means of grades. We've used our drop-down and it's set for weighted. And in each of our categories, our choice is simple weighted means of grades, followed by a value. This is the most popular grading method here at HSU. A professor says, for this class, your writing assignments are worth 20% of your grade, or your tests are worth 30% of your grade. Now, the reason we're calling this a simple weighted means of grades, in the test category, we have three different tests. We notice one has a value of 25, one has a value of 50, one has a value of 100 points. In this category, no test has a greater weight or value than any other test. All of those tests together equal 30%. If you want the 100-point test to carry more weight and more impact on the score, come back for our next video using full weighted means of grades. Notice also at the bottom, since we're looking at the test section, we have a 100, a 50, and a 25, and then in our category total, that's 100. That's not a mathematical error. In fact, this section will not update. In sum of grades, if you changed items or added an item, your total at the bottom would update. Not so here, because we're working in percentages. This is not 100 points, but 100% of this category, and again, we're speaking of tests, 100% of the test category constitutes 30% of the grade. So if you notice, the category total and all the way down at the bottom, the course total represents 100. Let me show you something else. If we come to the top, occasionally we get a professor, instead of weighted means of grades, here in the beige area, they'll choose simple weighted means of grades. Let's use our drop down and do that, and when I click it, watch what happens to the percentages. We click it, we reposition our image on the screen, all of those percentages are now gone. We're just taking all of these writing assignments in this category and weighting them against the total 100%. So if you want to give an actual value, my writing submissions are going to be worth 20%. Let's go to the top and change that back to weighted means of grades. And there it is. If you want to specify a percentage, 20%, 30%, you use weighted at the top, and simple weighted means in each category. Notice in our extra credit item at the very bottom in presentation, you can do extra credit in this method. However, if you uncheck, as we did in the last example, and I'm going to save changes, look at the screen, click, come down, absolutely nothing has changed, except that extra credit item is no longer extra credit. So give it a click, select Save Changes. This is the most common gradebook used here at Humboldt State. I'm going to go back to the front page, and I invite you, if you'd like to have a little more control, if you'd like to have one test way more than the other in as far as its importance, for heaven's sakes, that can be done. Don't feel bad about asking us. We're here to help, and we're at 3633. We'll see you in the next video.